Welcome to lecture 1 of unit 2 AICD, and this unit we will cover about operational amplifiers. I hope you are familiar with this term of operational amplifier from your previous course on analog microelectronic circuits. And I believe that you understand and you realize that they are definitely an integral part of many systems. When I say many systems, both of analog as well as mixed signal digital systems, this operational amplifier is an integral part. So we'll just start. In today's class, we will look at operational amplifiers, a general introduction followed by the performance parameters, what we will be focusing on the rest of the classes. And we'll also give a slight introduction overview about the various architectures available on operational amplifiers, right? So the very first point, what I want to bring to your notice is, this is an integral part, a very important part in systems. When I say systems, important part of both analog as well as mixed signal systems. So when I say this is an integral part of analog as well as mixed signal system, I should also tell about the applications, right? So where we use this operational amplifiers. So before looking at the integrated circuit application of this, if I am asking this question to you guys, how do you, like, what will you respond? What are the applications of op amps as per your understanding? So where and all we use op amps, operational amplifiers? Maybe you will be thinking about discrete applications, but that is perfectly fine. Yes, Bhuvan, that is right. Active filters. Yes, for filters, especially for active filters, op amp is a core. Yeah, other than filters, what are the other applications you can think about? ADC DACs, very good, Dhananjay. Yeah, for DACs as well as ADCs, especially we'll see that in ADC, analog to digital converter, this op amp is an integral part. Yes, so if I look at applications of op amp, active filters, ADCs and DACs. So mainly it is ADC where we use op amp. In DACs, there are structures, but in most of the time it is, yeah. So I'll just write ADC bar DAC. Yes. And any other applications coming to your mind? Comparators, very good. Yes, comparators. Yeah, if you remember the other applications, what we have seen in the previous course, definitely precision rectifiers. Yeah, I can see people are responding. Ashita, Bhumika, voltage followers, Schmidt triggers. Yeah, so there are a lot. So and if you look at the, so we have just listed out the circuits here, right? All right, like active filters, ADC DAC comparators, filters, Schmidt triggers. And now if you see the use of these circuits in our day-to-day life, definitely you can see ADC DAC in many systems, including our mobile phone, what we use daily. Then there are a lot of filters we use in our transceivers, again in the mobile phones, and comparators for voltage comparison, a Schmidt trigger in order to convert a sine wave to a square wave. There are a lot many applications in and around us with all these circuits. And if you look at all these circuits, this operational amplifier is the core. And if I ask you about the use of this op amp, so we have listed the lot of applications. Both you can see the applications are, none have listed oscillators. Even oscillators is another important application where we use op amps. If you remember in Wien-Bridge oscillator, what we have done last year, the last semester in the lab, that is again based on op amp. Multi vibrators, yes, Bhavya. There are a lot many applications, right? So whatever we listed so far, And your understanding, or maybe you have looked at the discrete applications. Now the only difference is we are looking at the applications of this op-amp in an IC. So in that perspective, if I look at the applications, and definitely as someone of you mentioned in ADC, apart from ADC, I'm not telling that the applications what I have written on the right side are important or less important. All are important, but with respect to analog IC design, we will specifically see the use of op-amp in ADCs in bias generation. So you'll be wondering, what is this bias generation? Bias generation is nothing but so in a circuit, I'll explain what is this bias generation circuits. Then you will also see this in PLLs. PLL is nothing but phase locked loop. So you will see the application of op-amp even in PLLs. All right. So coming to this bias generation circuits. Bias generation circuits are circuits which are used to generate a specific bias voltage. We call it as band gap references. So in any circuit, we'll have one power supply, and as I mentioned in one of our previous class, for all the other voltages what we need to bias transistors, we need to generate those voltages, and that is generally typically done with the help of something called as band gap references. And so for that also op-amp is used, right? So the applications for both the applications of op-amp is basically in the closed loop applications, right? Everywhere we'll be employing op-amp, either in the negative feedback mode or in the positive feedback mode. And in comparators, we go for open loop configurations, right? So anyway, we have to talk about these things in detail. But if you ask me in one sentence, how will you define an op-amp? So op-amp is basically defined as a high gain differential amplifier. I remember one of you asked me the other day when I was teaching about this single-ended differential amplifier with a single-ended output. One of you asked me whether this is an op-amp or not. Yes, all high-gain differential amplifiers are considered as op-amps. And when I say that all high-gain differential amplifiers, the gain can vary from the power 10 to the power of 1 to 10 to the power of 5. So you may be slightly confused about what gain I am talking here. So I have written it as high gain, but what gain I am talking about, I'll come back to that shortly. Before that, I want you guys to tell me what are the ideal characteristics of op-amp, what you have studied so far, or from your basic electronics or from your AMC. What are the ideal characteristics of op-amp? What are things you remember? Can I get some response? Yeah, it is infinite open loop gain. CMRR should be equal to zero. CMRR should be zero. Common mode gain should be zero, and CMRR should be infinity. Infinite bandwidth, yes. Infinite input impedance, all right. Zero output impedance, yeah, right. So there are a lot many features or characteristics you have studied, but we are listing this under the heading of ideal op-amp, and the very first thing what I'm writing is infinite gain. Infinite gain. What is this gain? Infinite gain. The meaning of that is infinite open loop gain. Open loop gain. Now all other things are infinite, right? Infinite input impedance, I'll write it as Zin. Then it was about infinite common mode rejection ratio, infinite slew rate, zero output impedance, I'll write zero Z out. Yeah, I can see even others have listed about zero offset voltage, zero bias current. Yes, all those are important features. Then infinite bandwidth. Yes. So these are the general characteristics of op-amp, what we generally talk. And if you remember, we have drawn op-amp, or op-amp was drawn in this form with inputs. It could be minus and plus. It is inverting and non-inverting input, and we also connect supply voltages to this. So this is input. We call this as inverting input. This is non-inverting, and this is output. And the other two are supply lines, right? And this is what you are familiar. And this we call it as single-ended. Single-ended op-amp. If we draw op-amp symbol in this form, we call it a single-ended op-amp. The reason is because you can see there is only one output terminal, and output is measured with respect to ground. So the output measurement is done like this. This is single-ended. But we know that even for differential amplifier, we saw that there is differential output. So differential. This is single-ended op-amp, and if you are asking me to draw the a symbol of a differential op-amp, fully differential op-amp, we call this as fully differential. So this is minus plus, and this we call it as plus minus. So where you apply input differentially, and output is also measured differentially, right? With again supply terminals here, and this is called as a fully differential op-amp. What do you mean by fully differential? Input and output both are differential, right? Now our study here will start by looking at this factor, what we have written as infinite open loop gain. Or the question is, how much gain is required for an op-amp, or why such high gain is essential for an op-amp? So can I get a response from you guys? Like, what do you think? Why? So we know that ideal case is infinite open loop gain, and that is not really possible. In getting infinite open loop gain is not possible. So definitely we can think about only some finite value of gain. But do you think such high gain is required for an op-amp? Because I have written here that is from ranging from 10 to the power of 1 to 10 to the power of 5. And I told that I'll talk about this high gain. This gain is actually open loop gain. Open loop gain of the op-amp. You will get more clarity on what this open loop gain is. So far we have written when we have discussed about the amplifiers, common drain, common source, common gate, or differential amplifier, everywhere we wrote gain which is open loop gain, because we haven't considered any feedback in any of those circuits. So whatever we have done so far is open loop gain. Similarly for op-amp also, open loop gain should be very high. And let us see the reason for that, or let us see what is the need of a high gain amplifier. All right. So I am just considering a particular scenario. If there are any doubts, please do let me know by just putting a message in the chat box. So I am just looking at one scenario where there is a requirement from a specific customer. So there is a customer who need an amplifier. And he has given the specification like this. The amplifier should be a high gain amplifier. So here high means nothing specifically given. He need a high gain amplifier, and that gain should be accurate, and he is looking for an accurate gain of 10. 10 should be the value. So the gain accuracy should be 10. That means whenever you design a circuit and when you get a gain of 10, that should be exactly 10. There should not be much variation in that. So are you getting the scenario? The scenario is a particular customer need an amplifier, and he need with an accurate gain of 10. That means when you design the circuit, your gain should remain as 10. It should not vary much. So what solution come to your mind when you see such kind of a need? Gain is only 10, but his condition is it should be accurate. So which circuit can I use for this? Can I get some response in the chat box? Feedback can be set. Okay, feedback can be set on what? Maybe you can think about the gain magnitude as 10. It could be even minus also. CD. Avinash, CD amplifier, you know that. What is the maximum gain available from a CD amplifier? It is common drain. It acts as source follower. And the maximum gain in ideal case is 1, nothing more than 1. So we cannot use CD here. Akash, I didn't get, you have written as feedback can be set, but I didn't get that. What did you mean by that? Any other thoughts? You need a gain of 10. Simple gain of 10. What comes to your mind first? You can think about it as minus 10 also. Yes, Bhuvan, CS, a common source can be done. Yes, that is the first thing that comes to your mind, right? Because we have seen the circuit so far as if I have a resistive load CS amplifier, right, with an RD of load resistance, we know that AV is equal to minus GM into RD. And it is not difficult to get a gain of 10 with the CS amplifier, because by suitably choosing an RD value and suitably biasing the transistor, definitely a gain of 10 can be achieved. Right. And here gain depends on both GM and RD. But if you look in detail, if you look at the circuit in detail, or if you look at the requirement in detail, we are supposed to give a solution for this by giving a gain of 10, but that gain should be very, very accurate. So when I say accurate, the error in gain should be very less. Maybe you can think about the error in gain should be less than 10%. What do you mean by error in gain should be less than 10%? So the change in gain can be 10 plus or minus 10% of that, right? So, or even you can think about the accuracy. So the accuracy will, the accuracy of the circuit is based on what application they are using. So if it is for a very high accurate, some designs for some applications, then even you can think about a gain which is less than 1% also. But if we provide a solution with this CS amplifier, this is CS amplifier, which is an open loop mode. This is open loop mode CS amplifier. You can easily get a gain of 10, but you can get easily a variation of this gain, maybe more than 20%. The reason is, you know that GM is a quantity which depends on mu and C aux, W by L, VGS minus VT, right? And if you look in detail, these quantities, mu and C aux, VT, all these will vary based on temperature, and all these variations can cause around 20% difference or 20% variation. Based on the study, around 20% change can happen. That means even though you design a circuit with a gain of 10, you may not be able to keep it as 10 all the time, because there are a lot of things in the sense, as temperature varies, there will be variation. So as process varies, there will be variation. As voltage varies, there will be certain variation. So we combine all these things together and we call this PVT variations. So with PVT variations, it is difficult to maintain the gain accuracy with an error in gain, the error in gain can go up to maximum of 20%. Are you guys with me? Are you guys following me? Can I get your response? Yes. So what I meant to say here is, if I try to design an amplifier to get an accurate gain of 10, especially in the open loop mode, there is nothing, since the amplifier itself is in open loop mode, we have no control over the gain of the circuit, right? Because there is no feedback existing here. There is nothing that we can sense and we can tune the circuit. There is no possibility of that. Along with that, you can also say that because of process voltage and temperature variation, the gain variations can go maximum up to 20%. And with that, I cannot give this amplifier for high gain or high accurate applications. So one possible solution here is to use an op-amp So when I say using an op-amp, it is not in open loop mode, but in closed loop mode. How will I use? You are familiar with this op-amp circuit applications. Maybe if you can configure this op-amp in a specific way, we call this as non-inverting amplifier. If you configure in this way, this is your Vout, this is your Vin, and say this is R1 and this is R2. If this is the configuration what you have, what is the gain of this circuit? What is the gain of the circuit? Yeah, power supplies are there. I'm not drawing it specifically. What is the gain of this circuit? Any idea? Yeah, so it is 1 plus R2 by R1. Yes, 1 plus R1 by R2. Since it is a non-inverting amplifier, we write the gain as 1 plus feedback resistance by input resistance, or the resistance at the other side. And this gain is not open loop gain. This is the gain of the circuit. And we generally represent it as AF, because this is the gain with the feedback. What is the feedback here? Feedback is employed here by using resistance R1. So this is AF, which is gain of the circuit with the feedback, and that is equal to 1 plus R1 by R2. So in this case also, so we always say that this feedback gain or the closed loop gain is equal to 1 plus R1 by R2 under the condition. We assume that the open loop gain is equal to infinity. I think you remember this. In your basic electronics, you would have seen that for an ideal op amp, this is the expression AF is equal to 1 plus R1 by R2. But in your AMC class, you would have definitely considered the practical gain or the finite gain of the op amp, because getting infinite gain is ideal. So in practice, you will not get infinite gain, you will get only a finite gain. And in that case, your closed loop expression will definitely go from this to a slightly different expression. I hope you remember that. Now, what is this? What you have to focus here is your A should be equal to infinity, and you are talking about the gain or the open loop gain of the op amp. So whenever we say A, this is nothing but open loop gain of the op amp. So why am I saying this? For getting an accurate gain of 10, this amplifier mode or this non-inverting amplifier is better. So I am saying this because AF is, we know the expression AF is equal to 1 plus R1 by R2, and this should be equal to 10. If this should be equal to 10, I know that R1 by R2 should be equal to 9. This should be equal to 9. So if I take R2 as 1K, I'll get R1 as 9K. Right. So I have to take two resistors of 1K and 9K. And I have to keep in the feedback and on the other side, and this will easily, I'll get easily a ratio of, if I take ratio, you will get around 9, and 9 plus 1, 10 is possible here. Right, one more thing, even now we can say that there will be variations, there will be tolerance for this resistance. So even we can think of finding the worst case value here, or you can also say that since you are taking the ratio of two resistors, such variations also will be small, because you are taking the ratio finally, right? So compared to your open loop mode of open loop configuration of a CS amplifier, it is very easy to get a gain of 10 with a closed loop mode of this type, provided the condition here is your open loop gain should be, I cannot say that it will be infinity, that is only an ideal case. Practically, your open loop gain or A should be very high. So why I am telling all these things here is to just bring to your notice that we are first of all we are looking for high open loop gain op amp structures. We are looking for op amp structures where high gain is there. So what is the use of high gain? If you have high gain, you can definitely use it for use that to realize very accurate, even small closed loop applications, right? So if your open loop gain is very high, you can actually go for a small value of closed loop gain, but the advantage is your accuracy will be more compared to any open loop configuration mode. Is this clear what I told? Are you guys following? Is this clear? Yeah, so if you have high open loop gain, it can be faithfully used for closed loop applications where you need a gain, even the small value or a slightly large value, anything is possible. But the focus here is open loop gain. Now the question will come to our mind, how much should be your open loop gain? So we always say that open loop gain should be infinity, but is that possible? No, getting open loop gain is not possible. Then what? So what is the open loop gain we are looking for? So I'll take one simple example, and with that we will see how much should be the open loop gain, and that always depends on the specific application we take. So I'll give a question here. The question is, calculate the open loop gain. Open loop gain is otherwise called as DC gain. I'll write that also in bracket, DC gain. DC gain doesn't mean that that is a gain given for DC. I'll explain what a DC gain is. Calculate the open loop gain of op-amp. For a relative gain error of less than 1%. Now one thing given is the closed loop gain of the circuit is equal to 10. So I'm again bringing the same scenario. You need a closed loop gain of 10 and the gain error should be less than 1%. So that is the condition. Now our aim is to find what should be the, for what value of open loop gain you can actually get an accurate less than 1% gain error closed loop gain. Right. So let me draw the same circuit. Because the gain needed is 10, and the circuit what we know is a simple non-inverting amplifier. This is input, this is output, this is R1 and R2, and I'll mark the open loop gain of the op-amp inside using this red color. Now from the expression we know that closed loop gain is equal to 1 plus R1 by R2. This is the expression what we have, or this can also be written as R2 plus R1 by R2, right? So why I am writing in this form is, so this is the closed loop gain. Now what about the feedback factor? So what is feedback factor in this case? Abhishek, you have a question?
No sir, by mistake.
All right, okay, no problem. Yeah, so the question what I'm asking now is, what is the feedback factor? How will you find the feedback factor? Feedback factor is this. So what is feedback here? I can say feedback factor as beta can be written as, say this is the feedback voltage. I can say feedback voltage is equal to output voltage into R2 by R1 plus R2, right? So the feedback factor is nothing but the feedback voltage by the output voltage. So VF by Vout, that can be written as R2 by R1 plus R2. All right. So the meaning is closed loop gain is equal to 1 by feedback factor, 1 by beta, right? Again, this is possible, or this you can think about this when your A is very, very large, or an ideal case A is infinity. I'll explain this again. So any doubt in this, I have written the closed loop gain or gain with the feedback AF, and I also wrote what is the feedback factor beta, and both are inversely related. The feedback factor is 1 by beta. Now if I look little detail about this, the whatever you are seeing on the screen, the circuit is a circuit with a negative feedback, and for a negative feedback system you can always write the relation between open loop gain and feedback factor as A by 1 plus A beta. I hope you have seen this relation, and this is used in a negative feedback system. So if it is A by 1 plus A beta, if I slightly modify this, if I take A beta from the denominator, I can write this as 1 by A beta plus 1, or this can be further written as 1 by beta into 1 plus 1 by A beta. Right. So, so 1 by A beta. Now, if your A, open loop gain A is very, very large, your 1 by A beta term will be actually very small. Or in that case, I can actually approximate this into, this can be approximated as 1 by beta into 1 minus 1 by A beta. So, you'll be wondering what I have done. This is same as 1 plus x raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 minus x if x is very small. Right. All right. Now, so if I look at this expression, so I'll just rewrite that. AF can be written as, what is AF expression? AF is written as 1 by beta into 1 minus 1 by A beta. So ideal case, if your A is infinity, this term will be equal to 0 and your feedback gain will be equal to 1, closed loop gain is equal to 1 by feedback factor. That is what I have written here, because this gain, what I'm writing here is assuming that A is equal to infinity. That is why you got the feedback factor as 1. The feedback factor is equal to inverse of closed loop gain. Right. Now, what is my what is the situation now? I want to find what should be the value of A, because ideally A is infinity, but how much should be the value of A in order to get a gain error? So the error in gain should be less than 1%. In that case, what should be my feedback? Sorry, in that case, what should be my open loop gain? So looking at this expression, even though it is approximate expression, 1 by beta into 1 minus 1 by beta into 1 minus 1 by A beta, I can say that this term should be actually 0, but in this case it is not 0, and this is actually the gain error term. Right, this should be A beta should be very high, or 1 by A beta should be 0 in the ideal case. Now I can say the error in gain is actually contributing by the factor 1 by A beta. So from the question, I can say that 1 by A beta should be less than 1%. What is the meaning of that? 1 by A beta should be less than 1% means it is this, or I can say A beta should be greater than 100. Right, A beta should be greater than 100. Now what is beta in this case? Beta is 100. So if beta is, sorry, beta is 1 by 10. So if beta is 1 by 10, your A should be greater than 1000. So what is the meaning here? So to get a gain with error less than 1%, your open loop gain should be, open loop gain should be greater than 1000 in this case, in this particular scenario when we consider. So what I can say, or what I can extend here is, there are lot many applications, especially when you go for a data converter applications where you need to convert the analog signal into digital. We definitely look at the accuracy of the voltage what we are producing, and in such cases we may need a gain error even less than this 1% value. Very, very small gain error we need. In such cases, the need of an op-amp with high gain is very, very essential. And the value of A depends on where we are using and what is our application. So the concluding statement here is, there is a need for high gain op-amps. So I just mentioned about only one specific application. So this gain here is the open loop gain, right? So the rest of second unit, we will look at various op-amp topologies which can give us high gain, circuits or op-amp architectures which can provide high gain, so that those circuits can be used for all such applications. All right, is this clear? I was trying to portray the need of a high gain op-amp by taking one simple example here. If you have questions, you can ask. I hope this example is clear. So let me just quickly list out the various performance parameters. So if I look for an op-amp, the various performance parameters needed for an op-amp. We call it as event specifications, or you can see definitely see these things in OPAM. So data sheet is where all these performance parameters will be listed. So the very first thing is gain of an OPAM, as I mentioned, the need of such high gain. Then we will see something called as ICMR that we already saw in DIFAM, input common mode range. Then we look at unity gain frequency, UGF, or unity gain bandwidth. Then we talk about the voltage swing of each structures, how much output voltage each structure can sustain. Then we will talk about the slew rate of an OPAM, how fast an OPAM can respond. Then we talk about the common mode rejection ratio, which should be very high in order to reject common mode signals. We'll also talk about PSRR, which is power supply rejection ratio. Then we will talk about offset and noise. So these are the various performance parameters. Apart from this, there are many other parameters too, but these are some of the important parameters what you can see in the data sheet of an OPAM. But in our class, we will not explicitly see all these parameters for all the architectures what we do. But we will definitely look at few of the parameters. We look at gain, we look at ICMR, we look at voltage swing. We look at these three, we'll definitely see. And other other structures or other architectures, we'll look at slightly more other parameters too. But these are some of the main parameters what we will be focusing. All right, so with this, I am just giving you the topologies what we will study in this unit, OPAM topologies. We will specifically look at three types. One is one stage OPAM or single stage OPAM. Then we will start our study by looking at differential amplifier itself. And we have two variants there. We have something called as telescopic OPAMP and folded cascode OPAMP. Telescopic and folded cascode, both are single stage OPAMPs. Now coming to the second category, which is called as two stage OPAMP, where we use two stages. So the first stage can be telescopic or folded cascode, or it can be a normal differential amplifier. But the whole idea of two stages, we will dedicate one stage for providing high gain, another stage for providing high swing, right? So the second stage will be dedicated to have high swing, and the first stage will look after the gain, the need of gain. And the third one is, we will see one technique, we call it as gain boosting technique, which can be applied to any OPAM structure. So that is basically to extend or to increase gain to a further high value, right? So primarily what we do is we will understand the architecture, we will see the operation, small signal analysis, and also look at how we can derive the gain and output impedance of all these structures. All right. So this is how we will progress for the rest of the hours, maybe another 7, 8, 9 hours. All right. So yeah. So with this, I am winding up for the day. Please stay online. I have certain other things to discuss. So I am winding up for the day. We'll continue in the next class with the first stage for the one stage OPAM structures. All right. Thank you so much. Please stay online.